you can see Robson's header didn't really gain an awful lot of ground. The volley going wide.
It was still a rasper, mind you, wasn't it? Didn't half catch it.
Sure was. Wide again. Sanson. John was saying that's going to be a real significant battle. Andy Pearce here. Lee Chapman, 20 goals to his credit. Batty with the throw. Long one it is too. I think it was Stuart Robson's head there. But McGrath just stops it going for the corner. So Batty will throw what is, well, as good as a corner really.
Oh, Brizovic came for that one.
Shoved in the back as he went for it.
I was a bit surprised that Grzovic came for that one, Brian, because he came advanced of everybody and got himself what I thought was a bit underneath the ball.
Chris White, John Newsom. Lee Chapman, you can see in the middle of the picture there, complaining that he was shoved unfairly in the back by Pearce. No point in complaining, just got to get on with the game, and it's such an important one now for Leeds United. Atherton gets it back. You've been with us all the time, forgive me, but there are of course people joining us all the time who may not know that Manchester United were beaten at Old Trafford this afternoon by Nottingham Forest. Means that Leeds, a victory here today for them against Coventry, puts them back at the top of the first division. Coventry, of course, with the defeat of Luton and Queen's Park Rangers, it eases Coventry's problems a little bit. They sorely need points to remain in the Premier League next season, or at least to go in the Premier League next season. 25 years of uninterrupted first division status for Coventry City since under Jimmy Hill they got there in the late 1960s. It's Gallagher. Speed and the referee, well, he did his best to play an advantage there because he could see that speed might just shrug off Robson, but in the end Robson's challenge was a little too much and couldn't be overlooked.
I think your interpretation was right, Brian. The referee was looking to play a bit of advantage there, but eventually had to call the foul.
It's a free kick then for Leeds. McAllister and Dorigo behind this. Chris White up from the back, so too is Chris Fairclough. Alistair playing it in. Well, the idea probably was for Fairclough to make a very positive move at the far post, which Chris Fairclough didn't do there. But it's a goal kick then for Coventry. They've won only two of their last 20 games.
That's some record when you think of McAllister there, eh? Hasn't missed a game in a season when there's so many players, top players, out with injuries.
Dorigo. Jin getting it away. Holding off Furlong. Oh, cheaply then, chipping the ball back to his goalkeeper, Lukic. Batty. Will Wallace get this one and be able to turn it back? That has gone into the box. Strachan's available short.
It was Pierce who got it away.
That is throw. Coming up to the 20-minute mark. 0-0 between Leeds and Coventry. Leeds in the whites. Batty with their throw. White trying a little flick on, gets it there the second time. Sanson's header gets it away. Gin eventually half volleys it away. Only gathers up though for the yellow-shirted Coventry. Batty again with the throw. A real little live wire in the midfield again this afternoon. And now a free kick for Leeds United. Keep this momentum going. Strachan playing it wide. Wallace turning it back.
A Krizovic just there before Chris Fairclough.
Solid knock, the big Coventry goalkeeper.
Well, Wallace did well getting that ball across, Brian. I didn't think he'd make it. He was going full pelt, whipped it back there. It was a good ball. And good goalkeeping again. So look at the pace of him and threw himself over the line getting it back.
Atherton offside against Gallagher. No doubt about that. Leeds warming up their substitutes, but I can only think that's just keep them warm and ready. Wilkinson doing a bit of shouting now on the touchline there. Pearson. Strachan again with the throw, picking up for Lee Chapman. Strachan again.
Right on the line, that one. Up for speed so well. Oh, and a good header that time by Robson. A very valuable header that one for Coventry.
Also a super header by speed. That's where he is so dangerous at those far post situations. Getting up so well. Here's Dorigo. Good spell this for Leeds, but you really get the impression here, don't you, that this Coventry defence is going to take a bit of breaking down.
I think they're very well organised, Brian, they certainly are.
Now what Howard Wilkinson calls a stingy team. They give very little away. But they've given away a corner there. Andy Pearce. Saying they have such an excellent defensive record. At the start of the day, only three first division clubs had a better one. Coventry conceded only 40 goals in 39 league games. Here's Strachan. White battling for it. There's Chapman with an extravagant overhead, optimistic strike there. Missed 6 weeks with that wrist injury, but still piled in 20 goals this season, following 32 last.
You know, the two big centre-backs of Coventry City are certainly playing well, and I'm not sure if Leeds would be better not changing the tactics a little bit here today, Brian, because normally they're looking for Chapman knocking balls in, but he's having a meagre time of it today.
In goes speed, ducking in with a header that time after Chapman on that occasion did beat Pearce.
I think I'm looking at people like Gary Speed getting in there, you know, Wallace, and maybe people breaking from midfield at McAllister. I think that might be the way in.
Gin. Flynn. It's Burrows who put the ball in quickly there. Atherton. Hit long towards Sean Flynn. In the end gets it back to Lukic. Robson. He wanted Flynn to make his run, but didn't quite read it that way. Thank you. a Leeds throw. Steve Hodges, who's not a sub today, but is quickly off the bench there, getting that ball back into play, also the throw could be taken. Leeds want to make every second count here this afternoon. Newsom's throw. Fairclough. Newsom, former Sheffield Wednesday lad. Brian Boroughs. Atherton. To Furlong. To Paul Furlong. There by Gallagher. Furlong shot will completely stubbed his toe on that one. Had a good start to the season for Furlong. He was rattling them in four in the first eight games, but the last one he scored for Coventry is away back in December. The goals for the moment have dried up for him. But he's certainly learning his business in the first division of the Barclays League. Jim. Free kick to Coventry. Jim with a kick. White with a clearance. Half going in there. Then Fairclough. Robson. Side against Gallagher. He's their top scorer with 10. And he was their top scorer last season with 16. But both last season and this, Kevin Gallagher had quite long spells out with injury. Formerly Dundee United player. Wallace. Newsom. Wallace again. Sanson. Touch there by Gallagher. Jin planting it down that left touchline. Gallagher dancing after this one. He's got Furlong in a lot of space in the middle. Just unsettling Lukic there just a moment to Paul Furlong. And took a knock as he did so. Atherton, but also had Boroughs to deal with. It's Leeds United's throw, which Gary Speed will take. Coming towards the half-hour mark, still Leeds United 0, Coventry City 0. Dorigo playing it in towards Wallace. Vigor Drizovic comfortably getting that one in the air. Forwards, Fairclough, who's missed nothing in the air at the back there, getting it away. Very Speed trying to get Batty away down this touchline. Jin has gone with Batty, and Atherton wasn't far away either. Working hard, Coventry City, showing great discipline in defence at the moment.
I think they've all been given a job to do as far as picking people up are concerned, Brian, and that's one of the reasons why Leeds can't get the game to flow in their direction at the moment, because all the key players have been picked up. If you look at Robson, he's on McAllister. You've got McGrath's on little Strachan.
Here's Chapman. Right inside, knocked away by Atherton. Sanson now. Flynn coming to this side. It was a foul by Newsom.